to do something greater for you, for my church, for my family. Lord, as I hear your word, may I become activated tonight in Jesus' name. Clap your hands and give God praise. And it's okay to take hold of your fire stick. Take hold of your fire stick. Just raise it up in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. With a fire stick, our prayer stick, before we're through, we're going to find out what it is. Hallelujah. Just wave it. Don't hit your neighbor. Just wave it for Jesus. It's only a piece of stick. Hallelujah. But God plus nothing equals something. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Please go ahead and do the neighbor check. If you've done the neighbor check, check to make sure your neighbor is okay. If they need an ice cream, give it to them. If they need some water, do the neighbor check. Hallelujah. And even when it is not announced, do it, do it, do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go ahead and play that song, sir. Please. Brother, take a shot. Hallelujah.
Same again. Can never return.
close the door. I would walk the path. I would walk the path. And run the race. And
thumbs up.
that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. Words of the Lord. Keep the fire burning. It is a priestly requirement. Hallelujah. One of the most important things about us as Baptists is that we believe in the priesthood of all believers. So by that very statement, you are a priest. Touch somebody and say, you are a priest. And by priestly, when you study Baptist doctrine and understanding of the priesthood of all believers, is that we have a right through Jesus Christ to have, we have access. We don't have to go and sit. Because we don't have to go through anybody except through Jesus Christ, who is our great high priest. So, hallelujah. We have the opportunity to come directly into the presence. Are you with me? So tell somebody again, you are a priest. You may be sitting on the keyboard, but your first duty is that of the priest. You may be playing guitar, but your first duty is that of a priest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because the truth be told, if you do not function as a priest, you can't play the music as you ought to. You can't sing as you ought to. And you will know that one of the duties of the priest is that the priest looked heavenward. Remember the letter star. He engages us, so he expects us to live look heavenwards. When earthly realities face us and bog us down, we are to look heavenwards. Hallelujah. You are asking the preacher, what are you saying? You love Psalm 61, don't you? How can you forget? It says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me. Evermore. You see, friends, I could just move, but you see, let me tell you, sometimes for people to really get it, because you are closer to them, you need to tell them, talk to somebody and say, you are a priest. You are a priest. Tell them, let them hear, priest. Keep the fire burning is a priestly requirement. But depending on where you are, when you hear this message, you may be encouraged. But it may also serve as a warning, or it could also serve as a rebuke, depending on where you are. This states some obvious things. A burning fire gives heat. Stating the obvious. But journey with me, because we are stating the obvious, we'll help you to connect later. A burning fire gives heat. Heat amounts to warmth and it affects the skin. True? A burning fire gives light. It appeals to sight. And sight, the eyes. Are you with me? A burning fire, I'm stating the obvious, I know you know it, also gives smoke. Stay with me. So far we have heat, light, smoke. Are you with me? I need to check if my young people are with me. Are you with me? So say it quickly. Heat, light, smoke. Smoke is a signal, it can be a sign. It can be a sign of life. Because if you are lost in the jungle, if somebody needs to pick you up, you watch it on Discovery Channel all the time. One of the ways to send a signal is to make a fire. Because the fire, hallelujah, has the capacity to send out smoke.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. But it all starts from the fire. Without fire, there is no. And sooner than later, if you do not have any fire that produces smoke, you are going to die in the jungle. Are you with me? But I want to also talk. It's not just jungle thing. Anybody know what hunger is?
Yes.
Young people don't know what hunger is. Anybody know what hunger is or hunger is? Anybody knows in your lifetime? You don't mean if you're hungry, no one will say if you know what it is. Alright. You. Please help me. Please pray for me. You remember when you were a child and you go to school and you are come from school and you're hungry? And if you look in them days they are not stove days, a firewood. So if you don't see nothing, I'll come out of the kitchen. He's ready to reap. So he lights the field. It's on fire. Hello? Stay with me, church. Where are my people here? The cane field is set on fire. Why? Church, are you really there with me? Burn away the child, the pain feel. So the fire will destroys the chaff, which is the dry bush that the cane produces, but the cane is not destroyed. Church, you think I gave you that old kid? Tell somebody has close business this. Fire of the burn, fire of the burning. No, listen. We spoke about the king here. We are all kings in God's kingdom. The production line can only go up after fire burns. Not to destroy you, but to refine you. Are you with me? Keep the fire burning so that the chaff, because the trash, the cane factory don't want that. And it's not only because sugar is brown gold, you know, but also we learn from scripture that gold, real gold, when it goes into the fire, it is not destroyed, it is refined. So it goes into the fire, but it comes out better than it went in. The only reason it comes out better is because the fire, hallelujah, in the process of refining it, destroys all the encumbrances, all the unnecessaries. I say to you, the cane farmer, I hope we have some cane farmer here, when he burns the field, he is able to have a better estimate in terms of what the production will be like. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And let me say to you, in a cane field, I know, for example, in America, my father used to travel farm work. It helps to reduce the possibility of certain things like snake and everything there. Because the field becomes dangerous, hallelujah, for you to traverse. Let me say to you that the place called Needham can become a dangerous place. That's why the fire needs to keep burning. So the fire of God can destroy what is bad. But if the good is here, the good will remain. It is only doing something for you. And I want to say to you, don't worry when you lose something. It's just God's fire burning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. If it was necessary, it would remain. But because when God's fire comes, it destroys the unnecessary. Are you with me? There's somebody, keep the fire burning. Keep the fire burning. Why? I'm giving you a good reason. Number one, keep it burning because it is God's fire. It is whose fire? God's fire. And I'm going to locate this now in Leviticus. Now, let us look at Leviticus chapter 9, verse 24. Leviticus 9, 24 says, fire. Okay, let me read from verse 23. Moses and Aaron then went into the tent of meeting. When they came out, they blessed the people, and the glory of the Lord appeared to all the people. Fire came out from the presence of the Lord and consumed the burnt offering and the fat offerings on the altar. And when all the people saw it, they shouted for joy and fell on their faces. Friends, what that amount to the fire came from heaven. They had built an altar, but instead of the priest lighting it, God himself lit the fire. He came from the very presence of God. So when I say keep the fire burning, you need to understand that it is God's fire. It's not your fire. It's the same God who said, let us, is his fire. So whatever is lit by God must be kept. That's where the people in partnership come. God gives the fire, but you, hallelujah, must produce the sacrifice. Oh, glory to God. that I jump ahead and say to you, the fire of Pentecost was not a new fire, it was really a repeat. It was a repeat. Acts chapter 2. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 2. We read it. The fire of Pentecost was a repeat. The only difference is, whereas in Leviticus, when the fire came, it rested on something. You see that in Leviticus, right? It came down on something. But when the fire came at Pentecost, it rested on someone's. Are you with me, church? I hope you're following in your Bible. So let me say to you, hallelujah, from something, and what I say, someone's. Because when it fell up, it said, there appeared to be tongues of fire, and it rested on each. So it means then that everybody needs fire. That's why I call you to carry the stick, because you are a fire stick in the kingdom of God. And if, oh Lord God Almighty, if grace is ready to be on fire, every fire stick is important. When God steps in, Pastor, he does not come for some. He comes to equip the church. Young people don't tell me that they don't have a fire. He said he rested on each of them. You are a priest, so maintain the fire. Maintain the fire. Let me say again, I want us to get it, that the fire of Leviticus, where did it come from? From God. From where? Check the fire at Pentecost. Where did it come from? It is the same source. The object may have changed, but the source remains. From something to someone's. Touch somebody and say, you have fire. No. That in Leviticus, when fire came, it came on a chosen place. In Acts, it came on a chosen people. When you have time, when Pentecost came, how many were there? At least 100 and... The 120 represent you. It represents me. It's 120. And not, we are not taking into account that Jews from every nation on earth were gathered there. Hallelujah. So from chosen place to chosen people. Hallelujah. From chosen something to chosen someone. I want to say to you, young people, I want to say to you, Grace, you are living in the right time. You are living in the age of chosenness. You are a royal priesthood, a chosen generation, a set apart people, chosen. So don't take this partnership for granted. The God, the letters God, calls you into partnership, but he also gives you what is necessary to maintain the partnership, keep the fire burning. The altar today represents church and ministry. Has the fire gone out in your church? Is it going out in your church? Has it been refueled? I asked three questions. All three may apply to you, or just one. Ask yourself, don't be afraid. Has the fire gone out in your church? Has the fire gone out in your life? In other words, your fire stick today, that real life. The oath. No. I am assuming that everybody knows about fire. But if everybody knows about it, then everybody do an experiment. So everybody gets it. Now watch this. Well, those of us who are used to wood kitchen, anytime you want a fire hole, why do you? true? Anytime you want fire blaze, what you know? Oh Lord, you don't talk about fire. You're afraid to say, you push it up. Shut the fire. But watch it. And this will soon get to that part. Let me say to you. Well, Grace Baptist is a firehouse. Glory to God. So why is it that we keep coming back every Sunday? Every Sunday we are coming together to push up the fire. Because when we leave church and we go on our own, the fire little by little is going out. And that's why we need constant coming together. Because, hallelujah, no, when the Pentecost, the believers, they were together. Because fire stick together, hallelujah, produces fire. You don't want it to trouble you. That's the problem with the absenteeism. You see, you have the fire collective, but you need to know that you're a part of the fire. So you have a responsibility when you leave church to ensure that your fire stick keep alive. And let me tell you something, if I just bang you up in a year, fireman. But some people are just burn the fire. Lord Jesus, man, praise God to me for tonight. Lord Jesus. Look, y'all go Google it. 100 meters. It's a long distance. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, wave your hands and give him praise in the temple. Charles Spurgeon, that great Baptist preacher, he says, the fire shall never be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. Keep the altar of private prayer burning. God Almighty, you're not hearing me. Keep the altar of private prayer burning. This is the very life of all piety. The sanctuary and family altars borrow their fires here. Therefore, let this fire burn well. Touch somebody and say, burn well. I don't want to be too polished tonight. I just want to be practical. You understand? But sometimes, Lord Jesus, I'm trying to say what I've been careful and say, but sometimes, if you stick with it, if your fire stick with it, with fire stick hard to catch. Let me tell you something, those people at church, I don't know the church, are you dead? If Lord Jesus, man, you come alive and watch. Watch when you put your fire with my fire and see. Hallelujah. If there will not be a change, hallelujah. Watch me now. Lord Jesus, when people look on, my God, when they see the fire, they know, say, hallelujah, there is a station, there is a hope.
Jesus, so if nobody is drawn people are drawn to light. No matter how small the light is, they are drawn to it. Did you not sing the other night, Pastor?